All right, let's talk about the reverse diet that I've been doing for the last about 8 to 9 months, I guess you would say. So first, I just want to start off by saying that this reverse diet was something that I just purely wanted to experiment with, and it's not something that I had to do or felt like I, you know, had to do to reach a goal. It was purely out of experimenting, but also because since lockdown, since I'm not training to compete, I've noticed changes in my body, and it's not always a comfortable thing. And the idea of gaining weight and my body changing felt really uncomfortable, and I didn't want it to be uncomfortable. I wanted it to feel like a normal thing. Our bodies change, everything changes in life, and I just wanted to be more comfortable with that. So I decided to do a reverse diet, even though I wasn't dieting. Now, what is a reverse diet? A reverse diet is something that you do to get out of eating very low calories when you are usually in a diet, or sometimes, not sometimes, all the time, bodybuilders and bikini competitors use the reverse diet technique between competitions to take them from their cutting phase to then a maintenance or a bulking phase. Now, I did not have intentions to bulk, however, I did build myself a hypertrophy program or a muscle building program back in March, which I followed when I first started this whole reverse diet. So my maintenance calories before I started any of this was around 2200, and have now since 8-9 months later increased to about 2600 a day, and my weight has stayed pretty much the same. So where do I start on this? There's so much to talk about with reverse diet, but I really want to condense it into something that's just really straightforward and something that you can understand. But what you need to know is that reverse diets work, and they are probably the most helpful tool to take you out of eating low calories into a higher calorie maintenance that you either just maintain and live off of, or that you build up and then diet from, and then you're dieting or you're cutting with a more manageable calorie intake. So for example, instead of trying to lose weight from eating 1500 calories to then like 1100 or 1200, you would reverse diet, say up to 2200 calories, and then diet or lose weight off of 1800 calories, which is a lot more manageable and enjoyable and healthy for people who do want to lose weight. So this was not a weight loss thing. This was not anything like that, just an experiment. So I started back in March. So I reverse dieted for 2 months. It took me 2 months to get from about 2200 to 2600. And then I maintained the 2600 for 6 months, or up until right now. And the reason why I wanted to maintain that 2600 for 6 months is because that is the time that is needed for your body to truly bring up its metabolism and catch up and make it the new maintenance. Because if you don't stick at that high calories, wherever you decide to finish your reverse diet, if you don't stick with that for approximately 6 months, your body doesn't have time to truly catch up and maintain that. So if you cut calories too soon, so say you're trying to diet after your reverse diet, if you cut those calories too soon, you're not cutting off of a new maintenance. You're cutting too soon, and it'll be very hard to lose weight because your body hasn't actually increased its metabolism. I hope that makes sense. That is the reason for the 6 month maintenance phase. Now, I do plan to stick here. I'm not gonna diet. I'm not gonna try to cut calories. I'm just gonna go strictly into intuitive eating and just eat the way I normally would. So maybe that'll be less, maybe it'll be more some days. So how do you go about doing a reverse diet? Your fitness and nutrition are both very, very important, and they work together. The whole idea is to increase your metabolism. So you wanna stop doing the things, or cut back on the things, I should say, that work against that, or that decrease your metabolism. So that includes cardio. Anything that burns a lot of calories actually slowly decreases your metabolism, because our bodies are meant for survival, and if you are burning so many calories, your metabolism is going to slow down so that it becomes efficient burning all those calories. If your body didn't become efficient burning a lot of calories and you just kept burning and burning and burning, we would just kind of dwindle away, and that is not how we're designed. Like I said, we're designed for survival. So you wanna cut back on the cardio, and you really want your fitness and your training to be focused around strength training, preferably building muscle, because that is what will help increase your metabolism. Muscle is very energy expensive, and it takes a lot of energy to build muscle. So if you are increasing your calories at the same time, that energy source will go towards repairing your muscle. So that's why you wanna focus on strength training. So I did 4 or 5 days of strength training, hypertrophy specifically, and then very minimal cardio. Like, I only did like 8,000 to 10,000 steps a day. And if I didn't get that, it was no big deal, because I'm trying to increase my metabolism, I'm trying to make my body work harder to burn the energy. I don't want to do the work for it by burning it on a run, you know? So that's what I did for the training. And then for the nutrition part, I increased my calories by about 50 a day each week. So I was increasing my calories, 350 calories total per week. And the reason why you only want to do small amounts, usually between 50 and 100 calorie surplus per day, is because if you do it too quickly, your body doesn't have time to catch up the metabolism. Our bodies don't change like that. You have to give your body time to adapt. So that's why you increase very slowly. And I try to increase mostly with protein to supplement my strength training. And I enjoy eating high protein meals. Like, I love it. Now, the thing that's hard with reverse dieting is two things: the commitment and the mental side of it. It is a commitment to track your food and plan your workouts accordingly, like change your workout routine to work on your metabolism. It is highly, highly recommended that you actually track your food very tediously, because you're trying to increase in such small amounts. If you're going to guess your food intake, then you're going to guess your results. It's just the way it is. This is a proven scientific way to increase your metabolism, so you really want to do it properly if you're going to do it. I know it takes time, it's a daily effort, and that's the hardest thing about it, is you really have to be committed, and you have to understand that this is what it takes to do it. It's very doable, but it has to be done. Like, things have to be measured and tracked. That's one thing. The other thing is the mental side of it. It can sometimes be uncomfortable eating more and gaining a little bit of weight, because you're most likely gonna gain a little bit of weight in the process. And by a little bit, I mean like maybe 2 to 3 pounds, but it's likely that it's mostly water, maybe a little bit of fat, maybe a little bit of muscle if you're really training hypertrophy, but that can still be uncomfortable, because you can generally feel, like, we know our bodies well, you can generally feel a couple pounds. You're like, whoa, like even around your menstrual cycle, you can feel that water retention. And by eating more food, higher volumes of food, it has to go somewhere. So you're gonna see that number on the scale, but it's most likely water retention. But it can still be uncomfortable and, you know, mess with you mentally. And a lot of people, that's when they wanna start overdoing the cardio, which is not what you wanna do, because that will counteract the whole process. And like I said, reverse dieting, the whole idea is to increase your metabolism. So you really have to be committed, and you have to trust the process, because it's tedious. But it works, and it's worked for a while now. People use this for competitions, like I said, bodybuilding, bikini competitors. I would definitely use this process when competing in fights. So it's an awesome tool. It is an awesome tool. The other thing is, you don't have to use reverse dieting only when you want to diet. For example, in my case, I just wanted to see if it could work when I wasn't dieting already, and I just wanted to increase my maintenance calories. So that's exactly what I did. So you can reverse diet and then just stay there. I've researched a lot about it. I just think it's great, because diet culture really makes us think that we have to cut the calories and increase the cardio. Now, that does work, but what do you do after that? Your calories are low, you've kind of maxed out the cardio that you can do, but you want to maintain your goals, and that's where a reverse diet comes into play. So I hope that kind of gives you an idea of how a reverse diet works, how I use it to my advantage. I hope that you've learned something, and I hope that kind of takes away from what the diet culture has just like hammered into us because it's just not healthy. Tracking actually really helped my relationship with food, actually, because I used to have this very restrictive mindset, and I always thought tracking would be something that would hurt my relationship with food, but it actually really helped. But anyway, I think that's all I have to say about reverse dieting. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments, because I really want to help educate people on this topic. And if you like these types of fitness and sport nutrition videos, make sure to like and subscribe, because I will be making more. And yeah, have a great day. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.